I'm so glad you're here. My name is Jonathan Sheehan. I'm the school principal here. I want to tell you something I was thinking about the other day. I was thinking, you know, I have kids. I have two 10-year-olds and a 12-year-old, and also have a 5-year-old. And I was thinking about my older kids. What I'd like to do is just go back and visit them when they were 2 and 3 and 4. Now, I don't necessarily want to live with them, right? I just want to visit them. I just want to enjoy sort of what they enjoy in life. And then it hit me. I want to be a grandparent. Like, I'm not even halfway through raising my kids, and I'm already looking forward to sitting where you're sitting as a grandparent. And let me tell you, you are the best audience that we have all year. You're enthusiastic. You pay attention. You make moves when people ask you to make moves. You always give a standing ovation, no expectation, but every year I've been here, you give a standing ovation. And it is so great to watch you watch the kids who are going to trickle in just a minute behind me. And I'm looking forward to today, and I'm also looking forward to Christmas break. So Merry Christmas. I'm going to introduce somebody who's going to come and talk to you. His name is Art Woods. Art Woods is the director of our development. And he's going to talk to you a little bit about what you have on your seats. There's a little newsletter, and there's also a white card that he's going to ask you to fill out. So if you want to go ahead and start doing that, if you haven't done that, you're welcome to go ahead and get ahead of the game.
Thank you, Jonathan. I'm a little farther down the road. I have 3 boys that have all graduated from the school, and I'm very proud to say that I'm a grandfather for the first time this past April, and we have another grandson coming this coming April, so we're doing everything to propel the Woods family name. I'm telling you, we're not going to let that diminish. We're thrilled that you're here. I'm looking forward to being where you are in a very few short years, just having, he's just 8 months old, but it puts you in a different perspective, I promise you. We are thrilled that you're here. Our office is really responsible for the fundraising in the office, and I like to say is really connecting opportunities with people who have a passion for things that are important to them. And we've been blessed even with this facility with people who were passionate about this school who gave resources to help make it possible. For over 125 years, people have been doing that. And so we're just there as a resource and a helper and to connect you and others with things that are important. And what I wanted to do is give you just, this is a very quick snapshot of some things that are going on at our school. And I wanted you to have that this morning just for one. The most important things are on the front because those are the things that are really what we're about as a mission and as a school. And that's, we have a young man who is now attends the university who is an alumni of our school who is now ranked in the top 20 amateur golfers in the world. Thank you, Greg. And he has an incredible future ahead of him. He has, and the really awesome thing about that is he spoke to our chapel just a few weeks ago and talked about the importance of the spiritual formation that happened in his life while he was part of the academy and how it has impacted his decision to be, and he's on a national stage, international stage, to be able to show his faith and talk about the importance of that. That's what we want to be about at Lipscomb Academy. It's about education, but it's also about when they leave here to be able to put that education into action and to walk their faith out. The other part of that is you should be very proud of this elementary school sent over 300 Magi boxes to Honduras this year. That was a project that's been passionate of one of our teachers that's grown over the years, and now this year we sent over 300 Magi. Just one of small things. Our elementary school did a whole creek renovation on the back that the mayor, I know you know about a lot of these things. I'm just telling you, I'm very proud to be a part of a place where we have our children not only learning, but they're also learning how to be servants in a world that needs our kids and their influence and their passion for Christ even more. So we're grateful you're here. On the back of that is also some news things about, we've just broken ground on an incredible new facility at our middle school, high school that your grandchildren here will benefit from. You can read more about that. I'm not going to talk about that more this morning. But if you have any questions or we can help you, please reach out to us. We're here as a resource to help you. We have refreshments for you in the lobby. Some of you I saw were able to grab those before you came in. There are donuts and cinnamon rolls and muffins and coffee and water in the lobby. So as you leave today, you can go out and grab that and just make yourself at home there. I want to introduce to you this morning Ashley Larmer. Ashley is an alumni of Harding of the academy. She's a lifer that came all the way through. She has just recently joined our office as the director of annual giving and is also going to be heading up for the first time our alumni office. We're very excited about re-engaging, and Ashley, having come through this school as a lifer, she graduated and then has been working at Vanderbilt the last 6 years raising resources for that school. So we are thrilled to have Ashley here, and I want her just to, for you to meet her and for her to make a few comments. Ashley.
Good morning. How's everybody this morning? Doing well? It's good to see your smiling faces. I know there are some of you out there who I perhaps went to school with, or are parents of people I perhaps went to school with. And I'd love to see a show of hands. How many people here are graduates of Lipscomb Academy? Anyway. Pretty good, pretty good. So in my role with alumni relations, I'll be reaching out to some of you, hoping to get to know you better. And for you other grandparents who are here, I hope I have the chance to get to know you as well and learn more about your grandchild's experience here at Lipscomb and how we continue that legacy. You know, I was thinking about being back here at the elementary school where I started many years ago, and all the things that have impacted my life and have then encouraged me to come back here and work. And I'd like to take a moment to recognize Miss Harvey, who was my first grade teacher. She's not in here yet, but she was, you know, so impactful to me and really helped me get on a good path. And these teachers are so passionate about your children and grandchildren, and it's just an inspiration every day to get to come here and see that at work. So if there's ever anything I can do for you, I hope you'll let me know. And I'll pass this back to Jonathan and let you guys get ready for the show.
One quick detail we didn't announce. If you'll pass the cards you've already completed to the farthest outside aisles, we'll come through and collect those. We don't want to distract from your grandchildren being seen. But if you'll pass those to the outside aisles, that two things, you want to have a drawing. The other thing is this just helps keep, make sure we have current information so that we can keep you informed about things that are happening at our school. Thank you.
Okay, and Mom, please fill out one of those cards because I would love this basket, and my in-laws are also here. If you guys want to fill one out, I would be happy to share that with you. I now give you your grandkids. Thank you.
Nana. Fun, awesome, swimming, walking, reading, dog, pool, ranger, golf cart, eating, dreaming, loving, funny, mother, grandma.
Thank you.
grandma. Nice, cheerful, cooking, pretending, sleeping, God, cookies, popcorn, movies, baking, walking, laughing, funny, caring, matriarch.
Good morning. As we're transitioning here, my name is Greg Glenn. I serve as head of school here at Lipscomb Academy, and I just want to take this opportunity to say thank you for coming here and being with us this morning. Jonathan hit it right on the head when he said, it's fun to watch your all's faces while you're watching them, because you're more funny than them sometimes. I'm sitting over there watching. That's good stuff. Hey, I'd like to take just a moment here real quick, and if you will indulge me. You know, Lipscomb is an amazing place, and it's really an amazing place because of relationships. And the role that you all play as grandparents is crucial and critical in that way. And so I just want to give a shout out to you all. If you'll help me with this, first of all, if you're a grandparent, I know we have others that are not grandparents here, but if you are a grandparent, raise your hand right now. Now, if you'll help me, okay, now put your hands down. If you're a grandparent that has three grandchildren that are currently at Lipscomb Academy, would you mind standing up for me? Yeah, keep standing. Stay up here for me. If you have four grandchildren that are here currently at Lipscomb Academy, pre-K through 12, will you remain standing? Five remain standing. All right, we got a winner right here. Let's give a big round of applause right here. The Bornsteins right here. We got a little prize for you. Again, thank you all so much for being here this morning, and just thank you for the role that you play in supporting these young people in such a special way. Let's continue on here. Thank you.
grandparents. I like them. Ask me why? Because they watch me at Monkey Joe's. Because they climb to the top of the Adventure Science Center with me. Because they patch up my stuffed friends. Because they let me help them with their iPhones. Because they let me play with the Wii for 6 hours straight. Because they laugh at my jokes. Because they make me chocolate chip pancakes. Yummy. Because they tuck me in my bed inside the great room. Because. That's why I like grandparents.
Thank you. grandmother, kind, sweet, caring, lover of cooking, who is able to make monster cookies, who feels my love, who knows how to be a good grandparent, who fears the Lord, who would like to take me to Buffalo Park in Mississippi, who dreams of our family living with her.
Thank you. chief. Fun, awesome, cooking, loving, laughing, iPad, church, games, prayful, shopping, playing, giving, smart, generous, grandfather.
Thank you.
Hey, did a fantastic job. Let's give another round of applause. I'm going to draw on this basket in just a second. Does anybody else have a white card? If you have one, just hold it up. And Art, okay, we're going to collect those in just a second. I do want to thank some people. Normally, we end with thanking Melissa Collins, but I'm going to bring Melissa up here for a second. I think she needs to come up here. She always has her back towards you. I want her to turn around. I want everybody to give Ms. Collins a round of applause for a fantastic performance. Great job. Thank you, Melissa. There's a handful of other people. Event management, ETS, Lucy Seifert was our accompanist. Kathy Music did our decorations in the lobby and around the gym. Our teachers and our kids. So thank you to all of those. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you so much. And I also want to recognize our kids who actually got up here and read a poem about their grandparents. I learned a new grandparent named Chief. If I ever get to choose my name, I'm choosing Chief. So, is Chief in the audience? Okay, he's not raising his hand, but I see him. So, that's a great name. That's Jake Esquieta's granddad, and also Harrison, Kate, Cooper, Rachel, Audrey, Matthew, Jasmine, Eli, and Clay all read poems about their grandparents. So thank you, fourth graders. Just give them a round of applause. Great job. I'm going to draw a name out of here. I'm actually going to go to the bottom. Let's see. Jimmy Coleman. That's Matthew Coleman's granddad. Jimmy's here. Jimmy, come on down. Cooper, Eli, you mind going and giving this to Jimmy, Mr. Coleman? Pardon me. You guys do it together, please. You guys go to the principal's office after this. I don't know whose kids those are. Thank you so much for being here. Here's what we're going to do after the performance, which is concluded. Great job, Mr. Coleman. After this performance, which has been concluded, we're actually going to let the kids dismiss to their classrooms where they will receive you, grandparents, friends, and parents. And they got lots of things they'd love to show you. Also, coffee, cookies are in the lobby there, and that's for you guys to eat and enjoy. And I hope you have a merry, merry Christmas. Before we end, I'd love to say a prayer for you and for the kids and for this holiday season. So let's say a prayer. God, we love you. Thank you so much for Jesus, for the light coming down and shining upon this world and really giving us hope and redemption and salvation and a perfect example. And we pray that we can be more like Jesus every day. And pray that we can see Jesus in the people that we encounter. And I will have to say that in these kids that I see on a daily basis, and even today as they're performing, we certainly saw Jesus shine through. Thank you so much for grandparents, parents, friends, and the relationships that we have. And may Jesus be in the center of all of those relationships. And it's through his great name that we pray. Amen. You guys have a great holiday.